10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
You look terrific, and we're late.
Oh, Mom, look at my hair.
You excited?
Oh, well, wouldn't be. Get a little windblown look. A little careless, Mom.
Me too.
Oh, my corset, my dumb corset. Mom, would you button my jacket?
Right. But come on. We can't keep them waiting forever.
Are you nervous?
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Thank you. In 1955, the very week she was featured on the cover of Sports Illustrated magazine as America's hope in the Winter Olympics,
Jill Kinmont skied down a mountain of disaster. Paralyzed from the shoulders down, technically a quadriplegic, she clawed and fought her way up another kind of mountain, up from total helplessness to what she is today.
One of our city's most respected educators, a passionate crusader for the rights of the handicapped.
I would like to present this award to you, Jill Kinmont, and proclaim you Los Angeles Woman of the Year.
Thank you very much. This is really an honor that I'll never forget. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Have you been doing your breathing exercises?
Yes.
Have you been drinking your 4 quarts of water a day?
Absolutely.
Have you been clamping and releasing your catheter to help the bladder stay elastic?
Yes, to all the above. And you can add to that the fact that I haven't had any nightmares for a long time. I feel great. And if I can't go to Bishop for my vacation, I don't know what I'll do.
Well, I don't see why you can't leave Los Angeles for the summer. But just keep in mind that less than a year ago, you almost died. An emotional jolt. Your resistance goes down. You catch a cold and... In other words, have a fantastic time, but don't overdo it.
Thanks, Doctor. Your grades did improve, Remember that. It's the truth.
That's because I really tried, Miss Kimmon.
Oh, sure.
Oh, that's not very nice.
Bye-bye.
Don't get any trouble now, Richard.
I'll try not to.
Daddy, I will. Bye-bye.
We should be in Bishop before sunset.
I'm ready. Oh, it just hit me. I spend about as much time in this chair as I have out of it.
Guess that makes you a pro.
I guess so.
Oh, Jill, don't forget the picnic tomorrow with Linda and AJ.
Oh, Mom, I'm so tired. I'm sure they'll understand if I cancel.
Listen, they've been planning this for weeks. Do you realize you haven't seen each other in a year? Anyway, it'll be good for you.
Okay.
Dad and I always loved this place right here. The meadows and the trees. The mountain. Look at it, Jill. Isn't it beautiful with that cloud over it?
This one is the landlord's. And this one over here is ours.
What's he like?
The landlord? I don't know. I never met him. I rented it from his sister-in-law. Now let's get unpacked.
And just look at us now. We were going to be great skiers, huh? One of us gets polio. The second falls off a mountain.
And the third nearly kills herself at the Olympics.
Wonderful. Well, I feel like celebrating. Come on, Linda, how about some more wine?
Okay.
Great, huh?
Mmm.
Just a little bit.
Ooh, fine.
What'll we drink to this time?
To life.
Some ice cream.
All right, get some money from your father.
Okay.
And one scoop only.
You know, you two have done okay.
Now all we have to do is marry you off.
Oh, no, Josie. And no more blind dates. No offense. And that goes for you too, Linda.
But there's this new guy that's working with Dave on the
whip. Oh, no skiers. I'm through with skiers. In fact, I don't even want to get married anymore. You know, it's different nowadays. A woman doesn't have to get married to be complete. I'm very happy the way I am now. The only thing I really need is some more wine.
It's so good to be home, Linda. I love these mountains.
So do I.
I feel like I can breathe again after being in L.A. all winter.
I really shouldn't have tried to come this way.
Why? It's not that deep. We can make it.
Are you out of your mind? What if we get stuck?
Come on, Linda May. Let's have a little fun. Hit it!
What the hell? Here we go.
Hit it, Linda May.
Okay.
Oh, woo. Hit it, Linda May. Woo!
Help.
Help! Help!
one on the right.
Isn't he cute?
Howdy.
Hi.
Hi.
How long you been stuck here like that?
A week.
A week? That's amazing. What do you say we take you up to the cabin and thaw you out in front of the fireplace?
So what if we say no?
Okay, we'll help you anyway.
Well, come on, Roy.
You just settle back, ladies. Don't take but a second. Okay, Jennifer, come on.
Hey, Mule Skinner.
Oh, honey.
Hey.
Oh.
You want my help? You can do that all by yourself.
All right. Okay. You want to write? Fine. Okay, Roy. You know, I'll push.
I don't want to get wet.
I'll push.
You push.
All right.
Okay, now, when Roy's ready, count to three and just give her the gas. All right? Okay, now ready, Roy? All right, ready? One, two, three, go! Stop! All right, now look.
What do you say you girls get out and push?
Oh, sure, okay, I'll get out and help push. But my friend...
No,
my friend...
You get out and push, and I'll count to three, and we'll all do it together.
Hold it. You drive, you count. I'll push.
Hey, you want me to pull, John?
What do you think, asshole?
Hang on. One, two, three. Well, what do you girls say about that fireplace now?
Sounds great to me.
I can't. I've already got a date. I'm sorry. Besides, it's raining. Come on, Linda. Let's go. Gary, can you make that more of a gradual incline, please?
Mr. McCoy said anything you'd like. If you want an elevator, we'll build you one.
Hello? Name's John Booth. I don't want to bother you, but I just want to make sure everything's okay.
I know you. Have you dried off yet?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm your landlord.
Well, since you're the landlord, how about fixing the television set?
Go get a screwdriver. Be right back.
I've been in this chair since I was 17.
That's right. You never did get out of that Jeep, did you?
Right. Thanks for fixing the television set. I sure like your house.
You call me if you need something. Anything. I'm around most afternoons.
I will.
Take care of yourself.
Okay, David, you want to try the first one? By the reservation today.
Who?
John Booth.
John Booth?
Our landlord. You should see his truck. The kids went nuts.
There's a great television special on tonight. I cut out the review from the Times and put it on the set.
Howdy.
Hi.
Chilly night.
You look real nice. Guess you're going out.
Yep. Yeah, I'm going out.
Well, have a good time.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll have a good time. Yeah. It's long.
Night.
Why didn't you ask him in for coffee?
He had a date.
Hi, John. How are
you? Oh, you give me a beer.
Beer?
Put your arm around me.
That is all. Carry on and we'll have to take the car to the eyes. Contact.
Would you put your hand on my shoulder?
That was close.
How's that?
Mel, please turn down the sound.
Yeah, what's the matter?
I turn you off.
That's not true.
Please take me home, Mel.
But that's not true.
Would you just take me home, Mel?
We're good friends. We're great friends. You're the only person that I can talk to openly.
We're great friends. But you won't kiss me.
If you can't feel anything, what difference does it make?
I can feel on my face. I can feel on my shoulders. Why do you think I wore this dress tonight? When it's so cold. Please take me home, Mel.
I want to kiss you.
No.
Yeah, I want to kiss you.
No.
Yeah.
No. No.
No.
That's a good girl. That's right. It's just a dream. Just a dream.
When you die.
What? I'm not gonna die.
Everybody dies. Everybody.
Well, I'm not gonna discuss this with you now, not with you upset this way.
Then when are we going to discuss it, Mother? When do you want to talk about it then?
When, Mother? When? When, Mom?
Hi, Teal.
Are you
going to
come along with us?
No.
You ride a mule?
No, I can't ride a mule. No, but I'll meet you all back at the reservation.
All right.
Oh, buddy.
Hey, Joe.
Hey,
Doug. All right, kids, come on. Let's go. Come on, follow me.
Come on.
Let's go.
Okay, kids, let's move them out.
Come on, come on.
Hi, John.
Oh, take it easy, take it easy, take it easy. So,
what are you doing way out here?
Oh, my family owns and runs this old pack outfit.
Is that right? Any discounts for family friends?
Oh, I'm sure we could work something out. You're that famous skier, aren't you?
How did you know that?
Oh, because I read that book about you.
Are you a skier?
Me? Nah, never.
How nice.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
I don't know.
Ugh. Jill, Miss Kimmont, if I seem all tongue-tied and dumb, well, it's because I never talk to, you know, a celebrity.
I'm no celebrity.
Tell my mom that, hmm? See, she's the one standing in the doorway over there.
John, look over there.
Your mother.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I gotta go back to work, pick up some stuff, so it's been real nice seeing you.
It's been nice. It's been real nice.
So long.
I used to spend more time with these, but I get around great with my chair, so I guess I get lazy. You still doing all your exercises?
Oh, more than ever.
Good. How's your landlord?
Okay, I guess. Why?
Why? Come on, Jill. Has he asked you out yet, or hasn't he? And don't give me any of that innocent look of yours, either.
Why is everybody assuming I'm so anxious to go out with him? I haven't seen him in 2 weeks. Besides, I think he's already got a girlfriend.
Well, I don't think so. I ran into his sister-in-law down at the market. She said he went through a pretty bad divorce about a year ago. It really shook him up. And he hasn't been going out much since.
Why start something?
Why not? You got something better to do?
That's not the point, Josie.
Well, what is the point? Look, I know you better than you think.
Lay off, Josie.
Jill, you're lonely. You're so lonely you could scream. And yet you're sitting here with the oldest friend you have in the whole world, pretending
I'm
that
leaving.
Nothing's wrong. No, you're not. Not until I'm finished.
Josie, please let me go. I know what I'm doing. You might think you know what's best for me, but you don't. There's a lot you don't know. There's a lot nobody knows.
Jill, has there been anyone since Dick?
What? You know I date.
Hey, it's me, Josie.
No.
No wonder you're so careful.
Josie, I have to be.
Every man I've ever loved has died. Dick? Buddy? My father? Josie? Sometimes it's so hard.
I know.
No, you don't know. You don't know. You've got full use of your hands. You can make love. You can have children. You can feel, Josie.
Mom, would you get the door for me, please?
Howdy.
Hi. What are you doing tonight?
Nothing.
I'm going downtown to watch the fireworks. Want to come along?
Sure.
I feel great tonight. How about you?
Oh. Yeah, I feel pretty good. Hey. Slow down, how fast you walk anyway.
Oh, I can go up to 5 miles an hour on straightaway.
Look at that green one.
Ooh.
So how many gears forward you say you got in that thing?
Well, it runs just like a bulldozer.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
So you were married.
Sure as hell don't want to talk about that. Anyway, it's the closest thing to a date I've had since I was divorced a year or so ago.
Oh, come on. I don't believe that.
Believe it. You know, I used to think you were kind of pretty. Stuck up sort of way. Now, well, now you're just plain beautiful. Oh, I guess you hear that all the time, don't you?
No?
No? But I keep expecting to see guys come in, drive to your house, take you out.
Whatever made you decide to be a truck driver?
Well, by the same reason you chose teaching, I suppose.
I teach because I can't imagine doing anything else. I love teaching.
Yeah? Yeah, it's about the same way I feel about driving a rig.
You never wanted to go on to school and study for a profession?
Me? Oh, never did.
You never wanted to leave Bishop and see what the big city was like?
No, never.
We're opposites.
Oh, I doubt that.
Will you take me with you one day?
What, you mean out on the road?
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Would you open the door for me?
Certainly.
Thanks for a wonderful time.
Yeah, it was fun, wasn't it?
It sure was.
Well, good night.
Good night.
Yeah, good night.
Mom, wake up! Mother!
What is it? Are you all right?
I'm fine. Just get me up. Hurry, quick.
What does he think he's doing? Doesn't he know what time it is?
Of course he does. This is when he goes to work, and he's taking me with him. So hurry, quick, go tell him. It'll take me a few minutes to get ready and to wait. Hurry, Mom, I don't want him to go without me! Carry me.
Now, I don't want to hurt you or pick you up in the wrong place, so you...
I'm just going to put one arm around your neck.
Here, look at this.
Okay. That's good. You put one arm under my legs. And the other arm on my back. Okay.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
One, two, three.
You did it.
Bye, Mom.
How am I doing?
Great.
Okay. There we go. Hang on, hang on.
Okay.
Your hand all right? Here, just move.
Great.
Well, you surprised to see me so soon?
Glad.
Good.
Thanks.
Good.
Woo!
Oh, people ask me all the time, aren't you lonely out there? Being all alone for so many hours on the road? I just smile at him, because I know that's why I love him so much.
What are we delivering?
We're gonna pick up some crude oil this side of Tonopah, Nevada.
John!
Oh, hell, will you look at that? Well, I guess I'm gonna go down there and see if I can get her out of that wire. I sure hope she doesn't kick my brains out in the process.
You watch out.
Baby, ho ho, ho ho, ho ho, ho now, ho ho, ho baby, ho baby, ho, ho honey, ho 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 ho, hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on, ho baby, ho, ho, ho now, hey that's good, let me get this out of you, hmm?
Go on. See the way she looked at me?
Sure did.
Sure was something.
Yeah. You sure are something.
Thank you.
don't mind if I introduce you to my folks before I drop you off, do you?
Of course not. I'd love to.
My family pioneered this whole valley.
Your family owns all this land?
Oh, no. We lease it from the city of Los Angeles, all 400 acres here.
Woo!
Mom, Dad, this is Jill.
Hello. Hi, Jill.
Howdy.
It's a lovely day, isn't it?
I'll get us something to drink, honey.
Good. John, would you go in with your father? I want to ask your mom something. Booth, would you please help me with something fast?
Oh, do I have to lift you?
No, just under my skirt.
I could have helped you with that back there.
You mean you saw that?
Yeah. Boy, I sure had a wonderful day.
So have I. John, wait. Is my corset showing?
The corset?
Mm-hmm.
No, everything looks okay.
Oh, would you cross my ankles?
Here we go.
Is that okay?
Okay.
Now, I'm warning you. No flirting with my brother. No flirting with anybody. Here.
Day.
Hi, Bev.
You remember Roy, don't you?
Of course I do.
The mules.
Listen, what are you folks drinking?
Beer?
Beer. Coors be fine.
Hey, Alice, bring us two Coors.
Folks, I'm sorry, but I can't let you sit here. The lady's chair sticks out too far and people can't get past.
Alice, what are you talking about? There's plenty of room over there.
It's a fire alarm. Can we just move to another table, John?
Sure. Come on. Come on, Roy. Let's move to another table.
Sure. We don't mind moving. Come on, Roy. I'll take these drinks. Just follow me.
Just wait a minute. I mean, just wait a minute. Now, John, I've seen them do this sort of thing before.
Do what before, Roy?
John, can we just go, please? Please.
Okay. Come on. We're going.
Use us.
Come on, Beverly. We're going with them.
No, stay, Roy. Stay, and we'll do it some other time. Oh, Alice, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
Roy, don't make a scene. You're embarrassing me.
It isn't true about those fire laws, is it?
Of course it is. Why else would they want us to move?
Jill. I love you, Jill.
I love you too.
What'd you say you wanted?
2 bottles of cranberry juice. My latest cure-all.
How's John?
Okay, I guess. He's been gone this last week. Comes home tomorrow.
Are things still good with the both of you?
I like him a lot. But he's younger than I am. And he doesn't have the slightest bit of interest in anything I'm interested in. Not books, not plays, not concerts. And he's so shy around people, sometimes it's embarrassing.
How does he
kiss?
And
his opinions.
How does he kiss?
Why are you pulling away from John like this?
I'm not pulling away. I'm looking at it sensibly, the way I have to.
I don't understand.
It's not important.
It is to me.
Okay. One day, when he gets over being destroyed by his first marriage, he's gonna want somebody that can do more than just keep him company.
I don't believe that.
I do.
Oh, Jill, please don't lose this chance. Please don't. I owe everything I am to you. And I can't stand to watch you do this to yourself.
What are you talking about?
If it hadn't been for your accident, Dave McCoy wouldn't have had time for me. I wouldn't have made it to the Olympics. I wouldn't be the person I am.
Linda, that is ridiculous.
No, it's not. It's true. And I can't... Don't you see you're doing the same thing you did the first time we met the guy? I've seen you do it with other men. You run before you even give it a chance to work.
Okay. Okay. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what really is real. I think I love him. I think he loves me, and I know I don't want to lose him. But I know something's gonna happen. I know it. I just know it.
Johnny, why do you like me?
I can't explain something like that.
I mean, you could have anybody.
I like taking care of you. Want another strawberry?
No, thank you.
I will.
Are you ever going to tell me about your wife? I'm sorry.
You're opposites, and I think that's all I have to say. Anyway. I don't have to prove a damn thing with you.
Am I enough for you, Johnny?
Sure. Give me everything I want. That's the truth. Jill, I got an idea.
Yeah?
What do you say we go away for a couple weeks? See how it goes. Maybe drive up to Canada and do a little camping out, fishing. Just the two of us.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? What's the matter?
Well, what do you say we just wait a whole lot longer before we talk about going away?
Why?
Because you just don't know how hard it is to take care of me.
That's why I want to do it, see? So we can find out.
I don't want to talk about it anymore. It's just too soon. It's just too soon, Johnny.
Jill. Come on, look at me.
No.
Jill, come here. Come here. Come on. Now, I want you to tell me what's the matter. What's wrong?
You just don't understand, do you?
No.
Well, I haven't had a boyfriend since Buick. And I didn't even let him get as close as you to me. And I just can't handle it. It's happening too fast, and you're pushing me. And I'm afraid.
Everything's okay.
I'm afraid. I'm frightened, Johnny. I'm frightened.
Don't
I'm
be frightened.
Frightened. I'm frightened, okay. Johnny. I'm frightened.
It's okay.
Please don't rush me, please.
I won't rush you, it's okay. But don't be frightened.
I can hear you in there with your coffee.
It's tea.
Mom, please get me up.
In a minute. I'm in the middle of reading something.
Guess what, Mom? Yesterday, John asked me if I wanted to go on a vacation with him. What do you think about getting rid of me for a couple of weeks?
You haven't answered me yet.
You're teasing me, aren't you? You couldn't go without me, and you know it.
Wrong.
Well, I don't know. I'll have to think about it.
June, I wasn't asking for your permission.
You've decided?
Not yet.
Be realistic. How could you do it? You'd need help. I'm the only person who's ever really taken care of you. I'm the only person who knows all your little quirks. How fast your temperature can soar. How to bathe you. Even your father never took care of you that way.
You're just as afraid of losing me as I am of losing you.
Yes, of course.
Mother, did you ever wish I died in that accident?
Oh, Jill. Don't you ever say that.
Then don't let me do to you what I did to Daddy. Take a vacation. Think of yourself for a change.
Well, do it. A couple of weeks isn't all that long. Be okay.
Goodbye, Dad. Take care of the doctor's got anything.
How soon do we get to Reno?
About 3 hours.
3 hours?
Yep.
Come on now! Get him down! Get him down! Come on now!
He likes him here. All right, take it down there and throw it against the line. The big seven. Ready? Look out.
Yeah! All right. Okay, we'll put it all 11.
Big 11. This time. Hey, everyone. Come on out. Get them all down.
Big 11, here we go.
You'll let me know when you need help out of your clothes, won't you?
Whenever.
What's that little smile for? Yeah, I am, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Guess I am.
You're so gentle. I like that the most.
Joe.
I guess it's exciting. Make love to me. Right now, I feel like I made love. Like it must be for everybody. Afterwards.
Johnny, I'm awake.
Be with you in a minute.
I want to get up too.
Haven't had my coffee yet.
Mr. Booth, I'm not in the habit of waiting for someone to get me up. So would you get your butt in here right now?
I haven't had my coffee yet.
Some days I really don't like you.
Well, that's just tough, honey, because I don't move until I've had my coffee. I don't hear. I don't think. I don't see. I barely breathe till I've had my coffee. You got that straight? Hey, you.
Hey. Did you really get away with all those stunts all these years?
Yes, I have.
Well, with me, you won't.
What are you, a tough guy?
Yeah. That's me. Tough guy.
What do you want first this morning? Kiss or coffee?
Oh, definitely a kiss. I mean, I can't move without a kiss. I can't breathe without a kiss. I can't hear without a kiss. You're a tough guy.
Try more.
I'm in reverse.
Okay, try forward.
Yeah. Back happening.
Wait, wait. Okay, try reverse. Ow!
Ow!
Oh, that was.
You're right.
Oh, that was my foot.
We're stuck.
Oh, well, brilliant. That's brilliant.
John, what are we going to do? I hate getting stuck anywhere. And the tide's coming in, John.
I can see that. Okay. I'm going to move you up by that rock up there. Ready?
So far.
Just sit down here and shut up. Be right back.
Yeah.
we go.
Oh. I can't believe it. We're gonna make it.
Well, was there ever any doubt?
Huh? My Hercules! Oh, John, it's so beautiful. It's gorgeous. Are you all right?
Well, what do you think?
What do you think?
I think we should get married. And I have to work tomorrow, so I won't be able to see you till about 3:30 or so.
Oh, I'll miss you till I see you.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Oh, honey girl. Oh.
Bye, Mom.
What did he call me? Oh, Mom, we had the most terrific time. And he asked me to marry him.
And you said yes?
No, but I'm going to.
Buddy.
Bill, how are the winds over the pass?
Oh, not so bad.
Get some sleep. See you this afternoon.
Well, call back. I don't want you catching a cold.
Mom? Mom, would you dial John's sister-in-law for me?
Oh.
Beverly, this is Jill. Have you heard from John? No, nothing's wrong. I just thought he'd be home a long time ago. Thanks.
A Bishop trucker was involved in a fatal accident.
Turn it back!
One of many on U.S. number 6 near Tonopah, Nevada. The driver was taken to Nye General Hospital and pronounced dead on arrival. His name is being withheld until next of kin have been...
No!
Hello? Hello?
Okay, I can tell you now.
I love you. And I want to marry you.
I'm going to hold you to it.
Soda Springs Airport? Say, I was wondering if you could tell me when Dick Buick took off. 2 days ago?
Jill. It doesn't mean it's him.
Then why isn't he here?
I'm sure he just ran into bad weather. I'm calling in a minute.
You know how he likes to scare people.
Well, it's a fact he enjoys dramatic entrances. I am so sorry. So, so sorry. Yes, I'll tell her. We all loved him very much. We'll miss him so much.
Honey girl, it's John. He's all right.
Hi, Mom. Some storm, wasn't it?
Hi, Jill. Can I come in?
Of course you can come in, John.
What's going on?
There was an accident involving a truck near Tonopah.
I know. That's why I'm late getting back. I had to stay and take care of the guy till the ambulance came.
Mother? I'm tired. Would you please put me to bed?
She thought the guy who died in that truck was me, right? Jill? I never thought for a second you'd hear about that.
Mom, please.
June. I'm sorry I scared you like that.
John, I don't want to talk to you. I'm tired. And I want to think things over.
Think what over, hon?
John, please go home.
I scared you pretty bad, didn't I?
I'm all right. I'm just tired. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Okay. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Closest thing to a date I've had since I was divorced a year or so ago.
Nope, nobody want to marry you.
Buddy, look who's here, Dick Buick.
I want to introduce you to my fiance.
Walk.
Howdy, Mom.
She's sick, John.
June, excuse me. I think that ought to do it. I gave her mild sedation. She'll probably sleep through the night. If there's any slight indication of a recurrence, I want you to call me.
Thank you, Doctor.
What happened? How sick is she?
She woke up in the middle of the night with a temperature. The last few hours, she's been having trouble breathing.
Why?
Oh, John. She's much more fragile than you realize. Physically, psychologically. Sometimes, without any warning.
I want to see her.
Not now. When she's better.
Just died. Dick? Buddy? My father?
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest me.
Hi. Glad to see you feeling better.
I'm glad you're here. I have something I've been wanting to tell you. I'm going back to Los Angeles. I was kidding myself that I could live up here.
What about us?
I don't know. Maybe I was just kidding myself about that, too.
Jill, what's going on? I had no control over that accident.
It isn't you. It's me.
Why are you so eager to write us off?
We're opposites, John. And sooner or later, our differences would just tear us apart.
Well, what makes you so sure? Since when did you start seeing the negative things? What happened, Jill?
You're a great guy, Johnny. And had a wonderful summer. But summer's over, and it's time to go back to work.
How dare you? I said, how dare you?
If you raise your voice to me, I'm not going to listen.
To imply or say we had, to call it a summer romance. Well, honey, that's one thing you don't have any right to do.
Going in.
Oh, no, you're not. You're gonna sit here and listen to what I have to say, even if it's the last time I talk to you. Now, whatever it is you're doing, lady, you're wrong to throw what you and I have together away. And whatever excuse you want to give it, I don't buy it. Because I know you love me. You see, you couldn't fool me about something like that.
Please let me through.
Would you, Jim?
If I don't see you before we go, I want to thank you.
To hell with you. To hell with all of you. Go to hell, lady. You enjoy being alone so much? Fine. Who am I to say a goddamn thing? I mean, who needs it? Who needs it?
I left the keys on the kitchen table, John.
Thank you.
I just want to thank you for everything you did for us.
June, you know you don't have to thank me for anything, really.
I'm sorry.
Mom, let's go!
You gotta get on your horse, Mom. Summer's over.
What'd you say to him?
Nothing. I just thanked him.
are you?
How dare you, you hick! That's a lie! He was coming to my birthday party.
I was only trying to get you to pull over and stop.
You hick, I wish I could hit you. You liar! You liar!
Look out.
I hate you! I hate you!
Why? Why?
You had no right. You had no right.
No right to what? To almost die? Or to come so close to doing it to you again?
Yes. Yes.
Jill, I said I'm sorry. What more do you want me to say?
I don't want you to say anything. I just want to go. I have to go.
But why?
Because I'll die the next time. I know I will. I came so close to it the other times. After Dick, I went into pills. After my father, it was worse. I stopped wanting to teach. I didn't even paint. You have no idea how hard it was to want to come back, to find something, anything that mattered to come back for. I love you. But I can't have you. I can't have anybody. Goodbye, Johnny.
What about me? Don't leave me, Jill. At least leave your door open. I'll go down to that damn city if I have to. I'll do anything not to give you up.
Johnny, please don't cry like that. Please.
I need you, honey.
You don't need me. You're whole. You're normal. You'll be fine.
You don't understand. See, all my life, I've never had anybody. And lonely, I've been so lonely. Except with you.
Johnny, please come to me. Johnny, please come to me. Please. I'll never leave you. I'll never leave you.